Hi guys, hope all of you are doing well. Today I want to talk about my jade plant. I have two varieties. One is this large leafed one, which is called an elephant ear. And the other one, you can see in that corner there, is the normal small leaf variety. Now, the care for both of them is very similar. I don't do anything different for the two of them. So I'm going to talk about this plant right here. The jade plant is a succulent. So what that means is that it stores water in its leaves. Now this does it. Why does a plant store water in its leaves? Because it obviously has evolved to do so, because it predominantly grows in areas with less water, desert lands. And since it doesn't get water in nature, it wants to store it in its leaves. And that is how it has survived through the ages. Now, since it stores water in its leaves, its root system is not developed enough to tolerate water. So if you overwater this plant, it will show its displeasure immediately by rotten roots and then the plant dying. Now, when the roots rot, what happens is it is unable to take in the required amount of water, and then the leaves show distress that looks like it is not getting enough water. Which is true, right? It is not getting enough water, but that was because you have overwatered it previously and rotted its roots. See the irony there? So the problem is actually overwatering and not underwatering, but it shows signs of underwatering later on because its root is rotted and the roots are not able to take in water. So if you see wrinkly leaves, just don't jump to the conclusion that you're underwatering your plant and then start giving it more water. You probably also overwatered it previously and the roots are damaged, and hence your leaves are showing wrinkles now. Okay, so the major problem for this plant is overwatering. So if you have your water right, your plant may not grow as ferociously as it may grow in the hands of a seasoned gardener, but it will still survive and do its best. So the only major way to kill this plant is by giving it so much water and drowning it. It can tolerate underwatering for over 2 weeks, but it can tolerate overwatering only for 2 to 3 days. So you get a picture right there what causes distress to this plant. Now I have planted this plant in red soil and gobar khad, like I do all my other plants. Succulents have their own potting mix where you make sandy soil and well-drained soil mix, which doesn't hold much of water. But I don't do that. I just put all my plants in the same soil mix, which is red soil, which is widely available in Maharashtra, and gobar khad. And my plants are doing very, very well, so I don't see the problem there. But you can, of course, if you're prone to overwatering, you can, of course, buy some sandy soil specifically meant for succulents. Cutie pies, come here. We have a guest today. Okay, moving on. So what are the other signs that your plant is not doing well? If you can see here, see these spots? Right? Can you see them? That's sun damage for you guys. Okay, so my plants are showing some sun damage. These are not new. Okay, these are probably very old and probably happened while they were in the nursery, because any new growth that I have is completely healthy. See, but I do have this plant in full sun. It is sitting in my east balcony, and guys, people think this is an indoor plant. I am doing air quotes here and rolling my eyes, because there is nothing like an indoor plant. How can, I mean, it's just common sense that plants can't grow without sunlight. How can you grow a plant in darkness? The basics of botany say that to generate chlorophyll, a plant requires sunlight, carbon dioxide and water. So without the sunlight, how is it going to turn carbon dioxide and water into chlorophyll? So do not put this plant inside your homes with low light and then expect it to grow. It'll shed all of its leaves, it'll become bald, and then it'll die. Okay, now indoor plants, I can go on and on about how people abuse their plants by placing them inside their houses in low light, but that's for another day. So this plant requires full sun. I placed it in my east facing balcony. It needs less water, so I water it about once in 4 to 5 days, once, you know, the soil is dry to touch. So I poke my finger in like this, and if I feel it is completely dry, see how it is completely dry and powdery and nothing sticks to my fingers, I will water it tomorrow, not today. So today I feel the soil is dry, I am going to water it tomorrow. See how I'm letting it sit in drought for a day? This plant likes that drought. Okay, its leaves will become thicker that ways. It will store more water in its leaves the next time it gets water. So that is how your leaves become more beautiful. So if you keep giving it, you know, water every time the soil is dry, then it doesn't require to store water in its leaves. So why would it make its leaves plump? It won't. So you have to show it drought for it to plump its leaves the next time it gets water. Okay, so now I haven't seen, as far as problems go, it gets dark spots if it's extremely overexposed to, you know, really, really hot sun, and if you water it with, you know, above room temperature water and such. It also gets water damaged if you're over pouring water, but I've really not seen any pest attack in this plant. Never, actually. I've not seen fungus attacks, I've not seen any kind of pest attacks, nothing. So, extremely low maintenance. Yeah, so there it goes. Now this plant can be propagated with cuttings. All you need is one node. What you have to do is, see here, okay? This is one node, two node, three node, four node. So all you need is one node for it to start moving. So pinch a 6-inch off, pinch it here, remove these two leaves and stick it in soil. About a month or so, you should see new roots. And this is a slow-growing plant, so don't fret over why my plant is not growing. So this was a 2-year-old plant when I bought it. It's been hanging here for another 2 years to, you know, show growth like this. Now it's bald here because I gave friends a few cuttings of this plant because of the large leaves. You know, very attractive plant. And jade, commonly available, is the small variety, which I can show you. I've put my aloe vera here because it's raining heavily in Mumbai and my aloe vera in its regular place is getting more water than it should. So I just put it in this corner so it doesn't, you know, drown. Okay, so this is the other variety that I have. This will be something that you probably will have at your home, right? See how it has grown ferociously. That's because I don't keep it indoors, and because I don't overwater it, and because I have placed it in full sun, east facing balcony, guys. So in the summer it is getting scorching heat for over 8 hours. See, completely healthy, beautiful thick leaves. And again, if I have to water it, I poke my finger in. See how the soil is sticking to my fingers? It means it has enough water not to water it. Now, as far as fertilizers go, I give it Gobar Khad. I've given it fertilizer last month. I am going to fertilize it again next month. Now, some people only fertilize their jades once in every 6 months or twice a year. But I do it because I'm giving it organic fertilizers. It's not as strong as a chemical fertilizer. So I give it every 2 months. And this is how my plant grows. If I've left out anything when I rewatch this video before posting, I am going to put in text scrollers in my video, hoping to answer all of your questions. If you still have doubts, just send me a message or send me an email. Take care, guys. Thank you for watching.